Kotel Alocha is the Filas Apayim Alocha Dalet. We are holding in the second paragraph of Seif Tes. V'iketachlis Shleimus HaTikun. And the final purpose, the completion of the Tikun, of that, of doing the mitzvah b'simcha, ומה שזויכין על די זה לסכן בחינס המסדר והמיישב וסמויכין שהוא בחינס כסר שהוא גבוה מן הכל. That's the purpose of doing the mitzvah בשמחה, that you arrange for yourself a mechanism that disciplines and settles the intellect, and that's the כסר, which is the highest בחינה of them all. ואף על פי שזוס הבחינה, this particular בחינה is, you know, it holds back the מויכן, it holds back the מויכן, you know, it doesn't let it run, it curbs its creativity, as we said the last time we learned this. It's not possible to have any asoga amitis, any true attainment, except through the discipline of the keser. So we're holding actually in the next paragraph. Ikir shlemes chus atzadik. The main completion, perfection of the merit of the tzadik. Shezoichel de masa vatikus. You know, that what does he get because of his good deeds? Shezoichel b'chinas keser shu gavua min hakol. When he attains that b'china of keser, which is the highest of them all, that's that thing that settles things down, that settles the seichel, and anchors it. That is the thing that enables, you know, the attainment, a perception of godliness. In other words, a perception of the infinite light. Zach hiluk sheben odom lemalach. That is the difference between a person and an angel. Sheodom atzadik, a person who is a tzadik, who gavoa harbe min hamalach, is much higher than a malach. Vikir achiluk, and the main difference, uvchinas asogas hakeser anon. The main difference between them is the attainment of that bechina of the keser. כי לבחינס הסוג הסקסר, to get that בחינה, that holds back the מויכן, and enables, דווקא that, enables, you know, a much, much higher הסוגה, this is only possible על ידי מייס התחתון עם דייקה בעובדוס ומס נטויב עם דייקה. The only way you can get it is דווקא through deeds, through מס נטויב. בשביל זה נברא האודם מזהוי. That's the reason why a person was created in this world. השופר לעבדו ולשום ופיקודים דעשר וזה לא עושה עשר. Person was created in this low and crude world, you know, material world, in order to cultivate the garden, so to speak, and guard it in mitzvah saseh and mitzvah lo isaseh. In order to get the keser, this is the tachlis shleimus adam. That is the ultimate shleimus of a human being. That is the thing that enables a person to be master of galakus. Hashem is baruch baruch hu miruma b'menusa lemala mikol ha'machshavei sabad moed. Kodesh baruch hu is way beyond any thought. Way beyond any thought. I saw a very provocative, not in the sense that it, you know, that it is controversial, but provocative in a sense, intellectually provocative, that really provokes the intellect. Reb Gedalia Koenig writes in one of his Mechtovim, yeah, that the entire Bria was done through Tzimtzum HaDa'as.
Okay.
it's akin to saying, they asked a very famous sculptor, made a sculpture, and the beauty of that sculpture is unbelievable. He said, how did you make this? I mean, it's made from marble, you know, chipped the marble off. How'd you do it? So, I think it's a sculpture of Moses or something. So he said, I saw the block, you know, and I saw the sculpture in it, the Moses in it. And then I just chipped off any piece which wasn't Moses off it. The entire Bria, the Kodesh Baruch Hu, the knowledge is infinite. So therefore nothing in exists. So the Kodesh Baruch Hu hid the knowledge, is infinite, in such a way that what remained became a world. It's something that really fires the intellect into very, very deep regions. In other words, the world is not build through addition, but rather through subtraction. It's just an interesting, Meruma and Menusa is way, way, way beyond all the thoughts. But it's Machshavat Fisa Beklal. No thought can possibly have any grasp in the Kodesh Baruch Hu. That's the reason why I mentioned that particular Maima, but by Rav Gedalia Koenig, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, because our thoughts are a result of, they can only exist because the Das was, the Kodesh Baruch Hu was limited. That's how the thoughts were created. How can the thoughts possibly have any grasp in the totality of infinity? There's no. That no thought can grasp the Kodesh Baruch Hu. And shum noitzer v'nivro v'nasser v'netzer l'mata v'lamala. There's no creation was created and done and emanated above or below that can be masik, because Hashem Elyon Noyre Me'oid, Kodesh Baruch Hu is way, way, way supernal. Na'ale al kol ha'soga shel kol dar emala v'dar lemata. Kodesh Baruch Hu is beyond any attainment and cognition and perception of all the dar emala and dar lemata, all those, the high beings and the low beings. V'chol b'ruah emala v'mata, and all the creations above and below will shake in fear just from the awe of his great name. Malachim yichafezen, and malachim rush, v'chilu ro'od yichazen, and fear and shaking grab them, b'zocham emes shmoy, when they just mention, when they remember the awesomeness of Hashem's name. V'zicha ha'godol v'ha'noyres boch v'yisor ha'netzach, And the memory of the great memory and awesome memory of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is Baruch V'Yisrael HaNetzach. As we say Birkas Kriyat Shema, we say V'chul HaMoisim B'Eimo V'Yiru Tzon Konam, and they all do with awe and dread the deed of their master. V'Yifani V'Chayis HaKadosh, and the wheels and the living beings, with a great noise, misnasim lumasrafim, you know, the elevate, you know, in vis-a-vis the seraphim, as it says in many, many psukim in the Rech Hazal, chol bu'emal v'mata, and all the creation above and below, kakol royashim u'boyarim u'mislavim, they all, you know, they all broil and burn and are excited and they chase with the machshava to be masig the asogas elokus, but there's no way to be masig the elokus of HaKadosh Baruch Hu except, you know, through in the bechina of mati velo mati, as we said before, and it's not possible to get that except through the asoga and the maisa of dafka the people in this world, dafka the tachtonim, because the main minia, what is the thing that makes the perception of Kodesh Baruch Hu impossible? It's ribuyar. It's too much light. You know, it's blinding light. Shiv shel kabelke, you can't contain it. You can't receive it. You drown in it. It blinds you. Veikia keli veichalois, the main tools and the chambers, the mental faculties, le kabela oba drogo vemido, to accept the light and to digest it gradually. You know, in accordance to how much you can, according to what you can sustain, b'chinas mate velo mate, you know, to the greatest, you know, the getting and not getting, nice similar day tikkun hakesar daikon. This is done dafka when the kesar, the limiter, the step down mechanism that controls the unbridled running of the intellect. You know, I want to know, I want to know, I want to get into the cut. It holds it back. That is the thing. That it is, it supposedly prevents the moichin from surging ahead. But this is the ikir asoga. That is the main asoga. And you can only get it through mitzvos maisis, as Chazal said, when Am Yisrael says nasa v'nishma. 600,000 malachim came down and put two crowns on their heads. Shenemo v'simchas oylam aloysha. You know, and eternal rejoice, eternal happiness is upon their head. Nimtza, it is therefore found that it's through Kabbalah Satoiro, Chinas Nasa v'nishma. In other words, the manifestation and the application of the Torah, the Maisa, the Wazoicha to Pchinas Kesa, this is Ike Asago. Because this world Asiya is Tachas Agashmis, it's totally material. This is the main, you know, curtain that blocks, you know, that stands between us and the perception of Asagas Elokus. When Yazoicha to serve a Kodesh Baruch in this world, indeed, and do dafka, you know, maisadik and mitzvahs with simcha, as I say, ikiratikun, this is the main rectification.
What is the simcha of mitzvahs?
Yeah, when you do the mitzvahs maisis, dafka la maisi, you do it besimcha, that's the thing that perpetrates the tikkun, the rectification. Because when you do the mitzvahs maisis, you do it besimcha. What you do is that you elevate that essence, that aspect of a seer, which in itself is the hurdle. That's the blockage. That's the iron curtain. It turns that which is, you know, is a totally opaque wall, which doesn't allow any asaga, you elevate it and you turn it into a productive tool. It becomes a keser. It uses dafka, that particular aspect of being a wall that stands between you and the light. Instead of keeping you from the light completely, when you're doing the mitzvah v'simcha, it elevates it and it becomes a tool to hold out too much light. So then you can prinas keser, from being a total wall, you're outside. You elevate it through doing the mitzvah until it becomes a tool in your hands to block too much light so you can actually receive the light of a Kodesh Baruch Hu by a drug of a b'mido. That's behind the klal and all the menias. You know, everybody says, like, you know, why can't I have Vedas Hashem, you know, without my knees? Why do I have to go through so much trouble? Why do I have to go through so much hurdles?
Why?
Because the hurdles themselves you know, it, when you elevate them, they become the kelim to the asaga.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
That is the kelim to the asaga. I mean, it's, how do you learn your profession? You run into trouble. You don't know what to do. Yeah. You break your head, you ask whatever it is, and you find out. And that, and, you know, that thing, which you didn't know, says, En odom oymed al divrei Torah. A person does not really, you know, internalize, you know, divrei Torah. Elem ken nichshal b'hem, you know, if he doesn't stumble upon them. You know, boom. Okay, now I get it. You know, it's like a... The problems along the way become the tool, you know, that they are, it's a double-edged thing. It can either turn your back, and say, oh, that's too hard for me, I can't take it. Or, you know, that in itself becomes a keli to that saga. As we would, and he said, Ma'alele b'chinas kesev, az nisapich v'nasa b'chinas asir. Then it flips over. It becomes from a prinus asiya, you know, the most materialistic, you know, and crude bechina. Because masa chamavdil, that's the iron curtain that blocks you from elokus completely. Nasa mimeno prinus kesa, that becomes the kesa. Shugankin prinus hamavdil, it also, you know, a wall. Beruchnis ha'elyon. Now it's a mavdil in the supernal spirituality. Ke kesa poros ben ha'netzolon ben ha'matzah. The kesa is like a curtain that is drawn between the Kodesh Baruch Hu and all those, you know, the emanator and the emanating. Now that is the, as it says in this particular Torah. Ki ha'kesa u'kmo moneo me'akim esamoichim meredifosom. The kesa is like a hurdle that holds up the moichin from chasing to grasp the light of infinity. Dafka, that particular blockage and hurdle, that is the perfection of the tikkun. That's the only way you can get the light of infinity. Nimtza shebchinas asiyah gashmis, as vis-a-vis, you know, doing the material crude deed, which is ikir amenia v'me'akev v'masach hamavdil, that's the thing that holds back and blocks and prevents, you know, the perception of the elokus of Kodesh Baruch Hu Yisbarach. When you are zoicha and you purify it, and you are mekadosh the asiyah. By doing the Mrs. Besimcha, Azai Mizet Daika Yikir Tikkun. That is the thing that achieves the main tikkun. It goes way, way, way up until dafka that. You know, that thing which blocked your way to begin with becomes the kesa that enables, you know, it still is a Monea Me'akev. It still fulfills that role as a preventer and a thing that sends on the way. But that preventer, that step down mechanism, that filter, you know, is Ikir Ashlemes Vatiku. You know, that's Sof Masa Machshavot Chilo. Just want to get on this particular Inyan, that first of all it explains that the Isha Teros Baal. You know, when a person first wants to get into Avodas Hashem, so, you know, that which a woman is not used to doing, that's not the way that things work.
Yeah.
So she started raising all kinds of balagan. Hey, whoa.
Yeah.
What's with you? All of a sudden you became Lubavitcher Rebbe. What's wrong with you? Well, you know, like, whoa, chill out. I don't want to live like this. I didn't sign up for this. You know, I didn't bargain for this. It's himself, it's Nesapach, to the fact that she is the one that makes sure that you don't run too fast and holds you down, and therefore your growth is sustainable. And we learned yesterday in Sipur Maisis, Avliyah learned this Indian of the Ben Melech, you know, with the behemoths in the forest, and they run away from him. And he thinks, you know, he says, I'm done for, either way. If I go back to the merchant, I'm toast. He's going to kill me. Right. If I chase the behemoths, the animals are going to eat me. You know, so why should I go back to the merchant? And he goes after behemoths. Yeah, and he says, Lichura, it's an insane decision. I thought, no, it's not. It's not an insane decision. In fact, the insanity served him. The insanity is that he thought that if he goes back, that for sure the merchant will kill him. That's the insanity, which comes to teach you, but once he held that either way he's done for, the question is, what am I going to do with this impossible task? Am I going to use it as an excuse to go back and say, well, what do you want me to do? Okay? Or, I'm going to do my thing. I'm going to do my thing. Whatever Kodesh Baruch Hu does, I'm going to do my thing, because that's what I was told to do. That's my matara. That's my... So that is that particular union. The same thing is the keser. It holds you back in one time. It all depends what you do with it. If you go after it, then it becomes a tool for us. So you see, it brought him to the tzaddik and all his tikkunim. Dafka that. It all depends, you know, the keser. Are you going to go after it? Or are you going to use it as an excuse? I mean, what do you expect me to do? I mean, the animals will you know, so a challenge is always, it says, is this, how do I know that this is a challenge, you know, that's made for me to grow, or this is a machshelo, this is a trap. I mean, I can't, there's no, it's all in your attitude. As they say, what doesn't break you makes you stronger. You know, it's you decide what it's going to be. Nothing that the Kodesh Baruch Hu brings upon your way is predetermined to be a machshela, unless it's for your own good. Unless it's for your own good that you bring the achshel. It's up to you what to make of it. Then even a machshela, even a booby trap, you fail. Because of your choice, or because of whatever reason there is, it's still, now it's a new challenge. What are you going to do when you fail? That's the bekias of Ritzav Hashav. You can always turn it to your benefit. A person didn't ever do tshuva. You know, it's like Uri Zohar said that now he's sober at 80 years old. So he said, I'm 40 years old, because until age 40 he was fried. He says, I'm 40, I've lived for 40 years. I'm 40 years old. So I told this Talmud, I told this Talmud, you know, what are you talking about? If it wasn't for the first 40 years, there are many Uri Zohars in the market. Yeah. You know, there's nothing special about you except for those first 40 years. But those 40 years, you know, he did, was a bandit, right? But Eitz Hashem Lo'elam Tamur, the Eitz of Kodesh Baruch Hu will stand forever. It is dafka. Then when you do tshuva, yesh inin shenisaf echakol ha'teva. That's what the Rebbeinu says. Even when a person falls and a person falters and a person does averus, yeah. even severe averus. If a person is in action and he's focused on what he needs to do, everything flips over and becomes an unbelievable toiva. Unbelievable toiva. You know how many tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of people, you know, did tshuva because of those 40 years that he just wipes off and says, I didn't live those years. Oh, yes, you did. Oh, yes, you did. It says, Tshuva me'ahava kol hasdoides nafrim mizuchlius, right? When you do tshuva me'ahava, you know, all the things that you did bechavona, they become schusim. What do you mean you didn't live those first 40 years? Who would you be without those first 40 years?
like a regular schnuck in the street.
You're the regular schlepper. When anyway, you're big time at Chacham, you're a Yosef, you're not a Har and a Tzaddik and everything fine. But there are many, many like that. But they don't have those 40 years. It's a small thing by you. Whoa. Oh. That's good.